Hello and welcome. In this video I am going to review Kubuntu 19.04. So here you can see I have just installed it. So let's see some system information first. If I go to info, you can see info center displays a lot of information about our system. I am using Kubuntu 19.04 and you can see the KDE Plasma version is 5.15.4. And you can also see it is a 64-bit operating system with 5.00-27 kernel of Linux. This is an old laptop with a Core i3 processor and I have 8 GB of memory. If we go to memory, you can see total physical memory is 8 GB and free physical memory is 4 GB. Let's go to device information and you can see device viewer and some other settings. If we start console or terminal, we can use the top command. Let me increase the font size. And here you can see currently around 1 GB of memory is in use. And I have also installed Chrome. And this is the default menu. And if you go to file manager is Dolphin. Here you can see it is in action. And one thing that I found is by default menu might be hidden, so you can just press Ctrl plus M to show or hide your main menu. And from here you can also show the filter bar or you can start terminal. I have a lot of files. Actually I switched from Lubuntu to Ubuntu without losing my data. I have published a video, you can watch that video if you want to know how you can install WordPress Pro, how you can install any Linux distribution with advanced partitioning scheme so you won't lose your data while switching from one Linux distribution to another. One thing that I find, if you right click you cannot see any option like in Linux Mint you might see open the terminal or start as admin as open as super user, but now in Kubuntu you cannot see this option, but you have the option to from tools you can open the terminal and it will open the exact location where you are. So now you know the file manager is Dolphin. And in some Linux distribution you can use this command sudo and then file manager name and it will open as root. Now it is not working here, or there might be an issue with command. I might be using the wrong command because I forget the command. Then we have system settings option. If you go to system settings, you can see a lot of options here. We have workspace theme. We can choose from 3 different themes. We also have options to choose a Plasma theme where we have Air, Breeze Dark and some other options. So let's choose BizLite and apply, and now you can see theme has been changed. Now we are using a light theme. You can also use the Kubuntu theme if you like this one. Then we have settings for cursor and splash screen. And if you go to colors, we have options to choose a color scheme for applications. We can also change fonts. You can see the default font is Noto Sans, and then we have size of our fonts. So let's choose general fonts. If I choose Manjari, let's apply this one. Some such changes as anti-aliasing or DPI will not only affect will only affect newly started applications. Okay, now you can see fonts has been changed, and we have icon theme. We can choose from different themes. Let's try this one, humanity, and let's apply. And if I go to file manager, we can see new theme. Let's try this one, the breeze one. So it might take some time to refresh. Now you can see new icon font. You can also choose application styles, desktop behavior. We have workspaces, desktop effects, screen edges, touch screen, and some other options. With screen edges, you can trigger an action by pushing the mouse cursor against the corresponding screen edge corner. Now here you can see, if I select, I have options, desktop grid, and many other options. We can run a command, we can lock screen, we can show desktop. So let's try this one to show desktop. Let's apply and minimize. And if we go, no, we don't need to minimize. Let's go to this. Actually, it is not working, but we can try it later. We have shortcuts, startup and shutdown settings, search, account details, and a lot of options. You also have options for power management, so you can see setting for, you can choose the screen brightness, and you can apply settings. Or you can choose the default settings. You can also see other settings for dim screen, screen energy saving, and some other options. Then we have KDE Connect settings. If you own an Android device, make sure to install KDE Connect Android app, also available from AppDroid, and it should appear in the list. Okay, so you can manage your calls, messages, and other settings. We have also pre-installed LibreOffice. Contact Discover is the software center to install and uninstall applications. Then we have Firefox, the default browser. So let's go to applications. Under applications, first of all, we have development. We have Sublime Text. This one was installed by me. Under education, we have two categories, mathematics and science. We have LibreOffice Math, and under education, okay, let's go games. We have board games, card games, logic games, and some other games. Under graphics, we have KDE Image Viewer. We have Color Paint. This is a very lightweight paint program. I personally use this program because it is very lightweight and has simple features. LibreOffice Draw is pre-installed. Then we have Ocular and Scan Image Light, image scanning application. And under internet, we have Aggregator, Feed Reader, Firefox, Yes, you can also install Google Chrome in Linux. Then we have Kmail header theme editor, Kmail mail client, conversation IRC client, and KRDC remote desktop client. KTorrent is also pre-installed to download files from torrent, PIM settings explorer, and Cyber editor. Okay. Under multimedia, we have Cantana music player client, disk burning tool, Pulse audio volume control settings, and VLC media player. And Simple Screen Recorder is a free screen recording application for Linux. This one was installed by me. And under Office, we also have LibreOffice, which is pre-installed. And if you go to settings, we have input method, system settings, and some other settings. Under system settings, you can see Info Center, File Manager, KDE, Partition Manager is also pre-installed. We have K System Log and K Syscart System Monitor. Let's open this one. So we can end process of any program if a program is not working properly. So you can see Simple Screen Recorder is using around 20% of CPU. If we click on System Load tab, you can see CPU usage. And memory usage. Currently it is using 1.1 GB of 7.7 GB. Then we have K Wallet Manager and Moon Package Manager. This is a package manager to install and uninstall applications in Kubuntu. So let's try both of these. Let's search for Kden Live. So you can see Kden Network File Sharing is installed, but Kden Live is not installed. So you can simply click this one and click installation and click OK to install your programs. Then you have Discover Software Center. And you can see applications, and you have different options and multiple categories. You can choose your favorite category, and you can also search your program. Kazam is a free screen recording application. Okay, Discover is not really fast. It is performing really slow on the system, but overall I am really satisfied with the performance of Kubuntu on this laptop. And if I right click on desktop, you can see some options. You can create new files and folders. By right clicking, you have a lot of options. You can directly create files using LibreOffice. You can also create HTML files, you can link to location and some other options. Then we have option for icons, so we can arrange them in rows and columns. We can also have alignment option and some other options. You can paste content from clipboard, undo trash, refresh desktop. You can also run a command, and yes, you can also add widgets just like Windows. So let's see available widgets. You can see activities, shows the activity manager. Okay, then we have activity bar, analog block, and yeah, you just need to simply drag and drop any widget on a desktop. If you prefer to use Bluetooth devices or Bluetooth headset with your laptop, you can use Bluetooth status control. And then we have some other widgets. You can also lock the screen quickly with Ctrl plus R plus L keyboard shortcut, and then you can also leave and open with Dolphin. And finally we have configure desktop option. If we click configure desktop, let's see some settings. As you can see, we have a lot of wallpapers to choose from. Let's apply this new one and minimize. Yes, now you can see new wallpaper in action. You can also choose a layout. Under wallpaper type, we have a lot of settings. You can also install some new plugins, and you can choose a positioning option. For mouse actions, you can see with the right button here, you can see a bug. Discover, close unexpectedly. Please report this error to help improve the software. So let's restart app. So there is a bug. Let's try to search our program again that we were trying to find earlier. Now it is working fine and it is working quickly. Let's search for Voco screen. Yes, it is quick. And we have Audacity. Yes, now it is working really quick and it is working fine. But actually we found a bug. You can see mouse actions, then we have locations and icon settings. We have filter options and we have tweak. You can see show the desktop toolbox, desktop layout, and then press and hold widgets to move them and reveal their handles. Okay. And I think this one will hide these options. Show desktop toolbar. Let's try this one. Yes. So you can also hide desktop toolbox, or you can hide. If you click on this, you can see a lot of options. So overall, I believe this is a great distribution, and on my system it is working really great. It is using only 1 GB of RAM while I'm recording this screen activity, and I was also able to install applications and some other programs. Everything is working fine so far. Only I found one bug that you saw earlier. Discover the software center was closed unexpectedly. So if you want to try this application, the process is really simple and easy. Simply visit kubuntu.org, download the ISO file, and then if you are a Windows user, you can use Rufus or UNet booting. We have also some other tools, and simply create a bootable USB drive and then you can install, or you can try it on your old hardware. You don't need a super fast computer. If you have a 5 or 6 year or even 10 year old laptop, you can install Linux distribution such as Kubuntu or Lubuntu, and it should work fine. Thank you very much for watching this video.